All right, can you hear me, a plute? Am I back? Fucking internet. I'm so sorry, the fucking internet took a dive here. Hopefully I didn't lose everybody. Hey! Thank you for the fucking patience, man. All right. Triangle, the abyss. Ship, Duster, 25 HP, 2.5 per shot, 2 second cooldown, 20 kilometers an hour, and a dash. All right, so we got a shift on dash, and that's it. Okay. Fucking go. I'm down with these bullet hell kind of games, and especially if it's gonna give me like, look, just to get this out of the way right now, I am down with these bullet hell kind of games. I don't mind that it's all Geometry Wars style. If it's gonna give me like, you know, look at all the stat lines that we have right now, just to like look at a character and see how you might be able to manipulate it. Let's see. Health, damage, cooldown, speed, spread, bullets, pierce, range, lifetime of the projectile, I imagine, knockback, XP gain, lifesteal, regen, a split shot, which is probably once it hits something, it then splits, bullet size, stun length, enemy damage, and critical chance. And there might be more, but if that's what it's got so far, that's plenty to make a really engaging development, especially if you have like a bunch of different items that are going to affect all that. I'm absolutely down with this style of game. I love it already. I love what the potential could be with what I'm seeing so far. And also, if I stop like this, it's just because I'm taking a safety meeting, you know what I'm saying? Just a safety meeting. I think everything is really safe over here. I'm OSHA 420 certified. Let's get the XP gain going. Also, I have never played this game before in my life, but I've played a lot of games that are similar to this, so I have some skill ideas of like methods of dealing with the weight, but mainly you just gotta get good. Weapon cooldown is pretty strong, but 15% damage is pretty fucking strong too. Yep, let's do another damage. Okay, we're pretty fragile. We only got 75 HP. Just extra health. It's not actually, it doesn't seem like it's actually a shield. It's just health. get a little bit of split shot going on just to get a little extra fucking crowd control here. I still like the damage. I'm still intensely digging the damage drops. We might be sacrificing too much fucking speed here. I don't like any of that. Right click card to redraw. Okay. Big boys. That's why we got the damage early. Those split shots are doing work. If you see when we hit those groups of guys, those split shots are doing super good work. We're gonna go again. I don't know if we just unlocked a new card since we took split shot to three or what just happened there. I'm not really sure. But you'll see that split shot is doing absolute work on those groups. And the penalty we had was that it was reducing our firing rate, but we're already increasing our firing rate. So the split shot with the fast firing rate, like we should be, I don't know much about this game, but we should be okay for a little while. Man, those things are quick. We need some more weapons. Yeah, we're starting to take a lot of damage. And they're starting to get a little beefier. I guess. I don't know how much it increases the crits by, but if we could get some more, that would be useful. That sounds like a boss. That was a boss coming in on the left. That was a boss coming in on the left. How much do we get? We have 18 crystals. I don't know how many we have 18 crystals. Do I not have enough? I don't know. I don't even know how many we have. Probably none. Let's try again. Maybe try a different approach this time. Oh, that's different. All right, let's do that. Okay. Give us a little bit of proximity control. Okay. I'm okay with that because we're going to manipulate our damage back up. I like this because we have two shots ricocheting instead of one. This is good. I'm not quite feeling the power like I did last time though, but yeah, we had a lot more damage at this point last time. What do you think about these kind of games of Plut? Are these interesting to you, even in the least, like the Vampire Survivor type bullet hells that you see coming out all the time now? Tell you what, I'm having trouble keeping track of my cursor. There's no cursor options. I wish I could like make my cursor kind of big and targety. I just wish I could make my cursor like big and like a target, you know. It's kind of annoying that it's literally just my mouse. Hard to keep track of. It's just hard to keep track of. Gonna get a little messy. I need that green thing. Give me that green thing. I think I need to, yeah, I need that. There we go. Mini boss spawn here soon. Oh, these little guys are gonna be the death of me, though. I can't fucking track them. There's so many, so quick, hard. The fucking axe is probably helping. Maybe we just give ourselves some health. Just to kind of buffer a little bit. Dreadnought. Barely. We need to get all this experience piling up over here. Boy's got some Neo Matrix level fucking skills here. I need that red shit. Yeah. I flew right into him, but man, we did a lot better. All right, let's see if we can afford a upgrade. If not, we'll move on to the next game. I'm just curious to see like what the pacing is here. All right, so we can afford, you know, a shield up. Oh shit, I think we can afford a little bit of each. We have 10 reds? No, we have 10 greens? I think we do. Yeah. We don't have 10. So we were able to afford one. Yeah. I'm pretty sure you got to go in order, most likely. Oh, no, you probably don't have to go in order. You can probably just buy whatever you want. All right, so it will get a lot easier, like the other games, like Nomad Survival, Vampire Survivors, and whatnot. We'll wait to take this on a deep run till later. I get the idea. I see what it is. I think I'm gonna comment at least to the degree that I can real quick, and we'll move on to the next. All right, top down geometric rogue light bullet hell. Very similar in structure to Vampire Survivors, Nomad, Survival, Spirit Hunter, Infinite Horde. Seems to have a nice selection of stats. Standard affair. Nothing out of the ordinary so far. Just a reskin. It's just a reskin of all the other games so far. I mean, I'm not talking shit. It seems to be done well. It's really pretty. Oh, here. I will say, the neon color schemes do make it attractive for those of us with an affinity to glowy things. There you go. That's what that one's all about. All right. I think at this point, maybe since everybody's put up with it so long so far, maybe I'll do a little bit of music streaming, and then we'll either keep playing games or take a break until I perform at 3 a.m. tonight. I'm not sure, but maybe we'll do a little bit of music. Let me see. Let me check a little something real quick. No, no worries, no worries. Cool, 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 cool. All right. What do you think, Upnoot? And I think you're my only viewer, so would you like to hear some music for a little while, brother? Kind of feel the vibe. Or let me rephrase that question. What kind of music have you been, participating with lately? What do you like to listen to? Have you been writing anything? What's been going on musically with you, brother? Curious. Anything? Safety meeting. All right, maybe we'll play a couple more games before we go to music then. Because it's just me and you. Next up. Play a couple more games. Let's do... Let's do Shortest Trip to Earth. I was avoiding it earlier. Maybe it'll surprise me and be fucking fantastic. We'll see. Oh, I forgot to turn the volume down, so prepare yourself. Here, I'll try to grab it real quick before it blows us away. No guarantee. Yep, I got it. I'll turn it down to like 20%. Hello from the developers. Visit the blah blah blah. All right, let's check out what 100% would have been. Not bad. Not bad. I think it's going to be FTL-like. I'm not sure. Oh, this looks complicated. More towards usual EDM and some bright ambient. Making a lot of different things as always. Well, feel free to link me up with something if you'd like. Hello, Captain. I'm Athena, the core AI of this ship. Welcome to the ship management tutorial. You're currently in Star System View. By the way, this tutorial uses default hotkeys only. Look at all these crew. Container, hybrid, point defense, internal modules. Internal modules. Engine. Internal, hybrid, container. Internal warp, internal weapon, internal weapon. Oh, hybrid. The four weapon slots, four hybrids, a bunch of containers, a bridge slot, and two missile launch sites. All right, cool. Well, now we know the layout of the ship. Start by installing the reactor into one of the internal module slots at the back of the ship. At the back of the ship, it says. Leave the front slots open for weapon. Let's see what. Leave the slot. Yeah, of course. Maybe we'll just put it right here. Start by installing it into one of the internal modules at the back of the ship. Yeah. Click. Wait. Left click, then right click to place it on the ship. Okay. There we go. Okay. Reactor generates power here, which can be used by other modules. Now install the organics container into the another internal slot. Feeding and healing your crew. Let's see, if the bridge is right here, then I probably want it right there. Fuel tanks. I'm thinking that these are the fuel tanks. I wouldn't want to put them on the outside where they can easily be targeted, but I'm not sure. Yeah, maybe back here.
Okay. Where's the container slot? I saw that shit around somewhere. Right here. No. Okay. Yo. Oh, okay, Basha. Okay. Okay, word. Sorry, hey. And please, if you're out there, Basha, just hit me up on motherfucking Discord, man, because I can't hardly see. I don't use actual Twitch chat. I use a separate program called Chatterino, you know, which looks like this. Hold on. I'll show you. YouTubers. I use Chatterino, which looks like this, and I sometimes can see whispers, but it doesn't come up in the same way, and I got all these different Twitch rooms open and shit. So it's just very hard for me to manage whispers. I can't ever remember what's going on with them. Oh, never mind. I'll take that off of there so I can read that privately. If you want to pick a time that we have Beyond Zebo is doing the flyer tonight, let me know. Yeah, I happen to be streaming right at the moment, brother. That's all. So any hour slot is open after 4 p.m. Okay, can I write you on fucking Discord, bro? Because I can't even respond to whispers in this program. Basha. Okay. Anytime after 4. Well, how late does it go? What time would you prefer for me to play? I get off work at 5 p.m. EST, so anytime after 6 is good for me. I like to play around 9 to 11 p.m. EST on weekdays. But I'm okay with whatever. All right, there. There you go, brother. That's all I can say about it. Let's get back into some space adventure. Command bridge can run many modules. Yep, we're gonna have to put that up here, I'm sure. Long range sensor kit. Internal slot. Aren't these internal slots? Yeah, they are. Another power reactor installed. Yeah. When you're done inspecting the modules, switch the view between your ship and your star system by hitting tab. Okay. I wish the text wasn't like 8 million fucking centimeters small. Like, please tell me that I can increase the text size. Please tell me. Yes. Thank God. I mean, I got good eyes and I could read that shit, but Jesus, yeah. Every third Monday, Spade. Oh, Spade's a good friend of mine. Single DMBs playing other genres. Yeah, I do that shit all the time. I don't know if you stopped by my stream last night, but I was playing motherfucking, Fidget House. And listen to this shit. Here, I'm not gonna play this game right now. I'm gonna fucking mix some music. Listen, I was playing Fidget House last night, and this is the way that I come up on it. And I want to share this because I think other people should know this for mixing and whatnot, or just to be thinking about it. So I have Virtual DJ 2021 now, as most people know. Let me pop it up and set this shit up so that you can see what I'm talking about real quick. I'll show you my exact process that I did for that set last night. Last night's set was an after party. I was the opening DJ for an after party after a big-ass party at midnight, and I didn't want to play I didn't feel like playing drum and bass, and I didn't necessarily want to play dubstep. I wanted to play house, but I didn't want to play, like, my normal kind of deep, dark techno house. I wanted to play fucking fidget house. And I don't really have a great supply of that type of music. What I do have is a legitimate license to my Virtual DJ 2021, as well as licenses to iDJ Pool, SoundCloud DJ, and Tidal in order to access online pools of songs of like 60 million songs or some shit. But it doesn't just hand everything to you on a silver platter. You have to know how the fuck you're going to get to what you want to get, right? So this is how I did that set for last night. Let me turn the regular NS mixer, my nested mixer screen off, and just show you the whole screen. And also, hold on one second. Let me just kind of situate it there for you. Pull that down. There you go. So, if you look over here on the left, you'll see that, you know, when you go to your online music, it gives you some options, which, you know, you'll have access to whatever you pay for. You know, I pay for those subscriptions, and it gives me access to like 70 million fucking songs. It's quite expensive, but, you know, DJing is a passion of mine, just like music production. I've been doing it for more than half of my life, and, you know, to me, it's like some kind of magic candy shop, you know, to have access to that many millions of songs. But, again, that's nothing if you don't know how you want to access it. So my exact method of action was this. I opened up. It's going to take a second because my fucking Chrome's going to crash. There we go. I opened up Chrome and went to SoundCloud. I turned off my VPN. It fucking sucks. I typed in Fidget House, and I went to playlists, and I immediately took all the top playlists of Fidget House and favorited all of them. As you can see, if I go down the list, they'll all be favorited, because then what happens is when I'll have to sign out. I'll literally right click and sign out and then re-sign into my account. Because when I do that, it refreshes my what I have access to. And what I have access to is all of my own uploads and music, of course. But then I also have access to all of my likes for the past 15 years of fucking just everything. I have all of my albums that I've ever liked, but I also have all the playlists that I've ever liked. And so all those Fidget House playlists that I just fucking snagged are right here. Now, that doesn't mean that I'm just going to go in there and start mixing whatever out of it, right? Like, I went through and spent like 35, 40 minutes picking out 30, 50 songs that fucking really, you know, I just quickly was browsing through. It'll fucking download it and load it real quick. I'm going to jump through and find the stuff that's actually got the vibes that I like. I'm gonna throw them into a fucking side list and then save that shit, and then I jump right into that set and just banged it out, and everybody fucking was going crazy loving it, and I loved it too. I like playing shit that's not, you know, not normally my thing. It is a little bit challenging, I'm finding, venturing into totally foreign genres, because even within the genres that I'm well established in, of drum and bass, jungle, deep dub, breaks and things like that, there's already a lot of arrangement and phrasing variability, and also just quirky shit that people do, you know, with like extra bars and spin backs and weird builds and shit. So you have to pay a lot of extra attention when you start looking at like arrangements of tracks and when verses are dropping and breakdowns and all the weird shit, so that you can, you know, so that you can fucking get your shit situated where, you know, you want it to fucking do the things, the double drops and the fun stuff. But nevertheless, I'm going to go ahead and mix for a little while. Clute, thank you for your patience of letting me take you on that little ride. But I can't stress to you guys how fucking incredible this is. Anything that you can think in your mind, you can just type in, grab the playlists, start pulling shit from it, and have a blast in some shit that you've never even fucked with before. And the more specific you can get, the better. The more specific you can get, the better, you know? And you're going to have access to... This was actually quite weak. If, you know, I can go down into my Raga Jungle lists, And there's motherfuckers that have lists with like fucking hundreds of tracks. Like this, yeah, look at this. This is a Raga Jungle list from a guy named Understone. Look, he's got hundreds of fucking songs in here. So this kind of method of, you know, this is the way I'm perspective, having in a perspective. This guy's taste might be fucking complete dog shit, but he's just another human being that has the ability to listen to eons more fucking music than I have access to, because the reality is there's more music coming out every 24 hours than there's 24 hours. There's more music coming out than there's time to listen to that music, like literally. Not. I'm not being facetious. It's not like an imagination. There's way more than one day's worth of music coming out every day, and it's not possible for all of us. You have to humble yourself a little bit and realize that it's not possible for us to, even if you just listen to fucking 10 seconds of a song and move from one to another, you just can't listen to everything. So I like to lean into other people's like effort in a chaotic, you know, fashion to start to corral things, and then even start to get, even if I don't like these tracks and whatnot, I'm eventually going to find a producer that's going to fucking ring my bell. I'm going to be like, oh, fucking Tribe Issachar, I've fucking been loving that vibe, let me go find more of their stuff, and it's at least going to turn me on to a bunch of shit if I'm not into that genre. So, you know, if you guys haven't recognized how powerful online DJ pool is, not just because of what it represents for what it can do for you in your performance, but just how it can open up new vistas of sound for you if you just spend 10 seconds thinking about how you can fucking use it creatively to fucking expand your horizons in different ways in what you do like and shit you have no idea about. It's fucking incredibly powerful. So on that note, why don't we just start fucking around with trying to think of something. You know what? Like, you know what would be fun is it would probably be a little too. I was gonna do some footwork, but footwork is I don't know how far it's come along in 2021, 2022, and it can. I think it can be a little questionable. I don't know. Let's see. Let's do it. I wonder if there's like footwork jungle kind of fucking right here. You know, actually, this is what I'm curious if somebody has made. Playlist called Footwork Jungle, because there's like junglistic footwork. So here's a playlist. Footwork Jungle. Let's just hear a few and see if this is even remotely what we're looking for. Yep, that's definitely what we're looking for. So let's just grab this. Get this guy. Might be fun. Halftime DMV footwork. Why not? Footwork jungle. Why are people putting footwork and jungle together like that? That's not either of those things, but that's okay. At this point, I'm willing to fucking entertain it, even if it's at the right BPM. I don't give a fuck if it's the right genre, but it does help if you actually select the right fucking genres, people. Now, this is stretching into multiple tempos, and I don't like that. Oh. Ooh. All right. That's enough. Let's modify this real quick to say that we're going to music, and then let's just get started with those. I'm just going to use those playlists that we just opened up, just as an example. I may or may not have heard any of the shit in there. Anais plays music from playlists he's never seen before. Random shit rolls. Let's go. What? Oh, I can't use the word. Yeah. Random stuff. Rocks. There we go. Random stuff rocks your face. So, remember, now that we did that, it's not going to just pop in here. So what I need to do is actually sign out of my fucking SoundCloud account. I gotta go back into it real quick and just give it at. I just have to reauthorize it real quick on a third party app. No big deal. I did click the I'm not a robot, you son of a bitch. Okay, good deal. There we go. Now we're good. Now, when I reopen it up, it should re-index my playlists and have those right there. Yep. So, let's let it index them each once real quick. Just these new ones that we got. I just want to let it index through them once so I can at least click on the folder. And that's it. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm only going to play tracks from these. Matter of fact, you know what? Today, I'll let you see the whole thing. Normally, it's just, normally it's just the NS Mixer view. And I don't do that for any particular reason. I just don't necessarily always show you guys the thing. How do you guys feel about that? Would you guys like to see the whole fucking kit and caboodle? Like, one reason I don't... Basha, we need to, if you're still here, Basha, or even a Plute, you know, my fellow DJs, we need to have a talk about what it means to, like, put in the work to find good music, and when other people ask you for a collection of your music, I've almost came to, tell me how you feel about this. I've come to the point where I feel like this. If somebody wants to ask me for a bunch of music because they like what I play, I'm actually not too opposed to it, but I'm not going to give them, like, a folder of what I've gone through and spent untold amount of hours sorting through tens of thousands of songs to come up with the shit that makes my selections what they are. But what I would do is give them, you know, the whole fucking thousands of shit that I sorted through so that they can then also come to those conclusions. But I don't feel like it's appropriate to just directly give people all of the fucking sorting work that I do, because that's really what makes me. And it doesn't really make sense to necessarily just always hand that. I have for a couple friends, but it almost is almost artistically kind of weird. I don't know how to even express it. I'm not trying to be selfish, but it just feels like that's a very personal thing. That's why I don't normally share all this, but in a situation like today, since I'm just showing you guys what I'm doing, I would rather just do this. So let's just go. I need to plug in my mixer real quick, but I'll start the first song.
Because of my fucking shit, hold on. Let me switch this up.
Is it over there? Get some rest, brother.
coming up.
Them song they are not treated.
dance.
Show name I love all of the gun them sin. With the show Marcus.
Tune in tonight from 8 to 11 p.m.
for the Anais Earthside Massive Pure Heart Dirty Mind Show. Every Saturday from 8 to 11 p.m. More like 8 to 10 p.m. tonight. Because we got a hip-hop show at 3 a.m. All times Eastern Standard. Like I said, I got my set coming up at 8 p.m., so I just wanted to show you guys how to do that. Aplute, go get yourself some rest. Basha and whomever is out there lurking me for some reason for hours and not saying shit. I love y'all still. And I hope you enjoy my friend, the Dayquil. He's dope as fuck. We'll come back at you more tomorrow with some more games, some more music. Tonight, in 2 hours and 17 minutes, Anais will be live, wrecking it down for hours at the Earthside Massive Show. And once again at 3 a.m. at the VR Palace in VR Chat. Some old school hip hop. Come fuck with me. Come fuck with me. In the meantime, go fuck with Dayquil. In a second, and I'll send you over there. I need to charge my wireless headphones anyway.
Can't we just talk to the humans a little about how they could make things better? Can't we talk to the humans that work together now?
No, because they are dead.
I said the humans are dead.
I'm glad they are dead.
The humans are dead.
I know that they're dead.
Come on, sucker, lick my battery.
Make him say,
Microphone.
Let's crack in.
What was the other one?
Yo, Uncle Anias.
Would that be
just chilling before the radio show, a couple hours.
Oh, the Your Heart, Your Mind.
That's the one.
Nice.
I think it's right. I got a show at VR Power. I'm talking about his seconds.
He's amazing.
He is, bro.